Hi everyone, welcome you all. So in our previous videos, we have seen two different type of dropdowns. So one is the dropdown which is having select tag, where we can select one option at a time. The other type of dropdown is multi-select dropdown, where we can select multiple options, right? So now I'm going to show you another type of dropdown called bootstrap dropdown. So this bootstrap dropdown is not basically having any select tag in our HTML. And we can see either div tag or sometimes you can see button tag and so on. So basically, which doesn't have a select tag in your HTML. So we can call them as a bootstrap dropdown. And in the bootstrap dropdown, sometimes we can select a single value at a time, or we can also select multiple values. Again, in the bootstrap, there are different type of dropdowns. So let me show you an example how the bootstrap dropdown will be. And now whatever I'm going to show you now is, which is a bootstrap dropdown, and in which we can select multiple options. Okay, I go back here. So this is a dropdown, bootstrap dropdown. And here we can also select multiple options. And every option is having one checkbox also. You can see by default, HTML CSS has got selected. If you want to select some other options, you can select like this. So this is a bootstrap dropdown along with multi-select. Okay, so let us see how to handle this dropdown and what kind of assertions we can add in this particular dropdown. So if I go back to my VS Code editor, I already created one spec file, bootstrap dropdown.spec.js, and I have imported test and expect functions from the Playwright test module, and then I have written the test function. Inside this, I put some description or title of the test and then as a crash page feature, and then I'm launching my web page. Okay, now let us start. The first thing is, we will see how many options are there in my dropdown. So how many total number of options present inside the dropdown, we will count. So for that, we need to properly write proper XPath. So let's inspect this element first. If you try to inspect and go back to selector hub, and you can see it is generated relative XPath and CSS and so on. But if I use this relative CSS, this will not always match, because currently HTML CSS got selected so that these options are showing here. Suppose if you select some more options tomorrow, the same CSS will not work. So we need to write a proper CSS which will able to locate that element every time. Okay, so if I look at this, there is a class attribute. So basically it's a button. Okay, and in this button, you can see there is no select tag, just button tag is there, right? So you can see type, class, and some other attributes are there. So this title attribute keeps changing based upon the options we have selected. So we cannot rely on the title. So the next option is what? We have a class attribute. Let me try with the class attribute. You can say I'm writing CSS. So when I use class, you can say dot, I can say multi-select. Okay, when I say multi-select, yeah, it is also matching, but later, by using the CSS, again, if you want to capture these all the elements, again becomes a problem. So I'm going to write another type of XPath. If I look at here, basically we have to point that options which are present inside the this particular box. Okay. So for that, what we need to do, first we need to click on this element, because until unless we click on this element, we will not get these options. Okay. So for that, what I will do is whatever the XPath I have written, dot multi-select. Dot multi-select. So this this particular CSS I just want to use to locate this dropdown, and clicking on the dropdown. So then we can see the rest of the options. Okay. Now go back to the VS Code editor. Now await page dot locator and specify the selector here and dot clicker. So we can directly call clicker. So this will perform the click action on the drop down element, so the rest of options will be visible. So now we need to count how many options are there in the drop down. So we need to write one XPath, or we can write a CSS, whatever, so which will able to match all these items. Okay, so where exactly these options are there in the HTML? If I look at here, HTML, there is a UL tag, user list. Inside this, there are multiple li tags are there. You can see each and every li is representing the options which are present inside this drop down. Okay, so now I'm going to write one CSS properly. You can say first let's start with the UL. Okay, UL is a tag, so I can say UL, and one element is matching. Inside the UL, there are multiple LIs are there. So now inside the UL, I say LI is another tag. Now 14 elements are matching. And again, in the 14 elements, there are some headings are there, web development, programming languages, database. There are not actual options, right? So I just want to eliminate those options. I want to get only the actual options which are having checkboxes. So in the LI, if I look at this, any LI, inside the anchor tag, inside the label, actual input, inside the label, there is an input, actually input box. This is we have to capture. So what I'll do is inside the LI, and I will go to label, and inside the label, now you can say when I say label, everything is got selected. Web development, programming languages, database, everything is got selected, but I just want to avoid them. So inside the label, let's go back to the input. So exactly, see, 11 elements are matching. So only the checkboxes, the options have been selected. Now this is the CSS I just want to use to locate those options. Okay, now go back to VS Code Editor. Now after clicking on that, it will open the dropdown. Now the first assertion I will give, what is that? First, let us capture those options. Await page dot locator and specify the locator. So this will return all the options and then I'll store them in a variable called options and I make it as a const variable. Now I can put one assertion. How many options are there? Simply I can say await expect assertion expect, and whatever options I captured, how many should be there? We can call to have counter. So exactly how many we are expecting is, we are expecting 11 options should be there. So this is our assertion. Fine. So we can just click on the dropdown. So this option will statement will click on the dropdown and then we'll capture all the options into the variable. And then we are expecting count should be 11. So let us try to execute this assertion and see. Save. And then let me open my terminal and run this command. So npx play rate test. Inside the test, I'm just running my spec file, bootstrap dropdown dot spec dot js, and I'm just trying to only in the Chromium browser. I just want to run in the headed mode, -- headed. So no test found. So I think the name is not properly matching. Let me save this properly. Okay, let me save it. So no test found means the name is not properly matched. So let me cross check once again. So npx play rate. Bootstrap, yeah, spelling mistake actually. This is boot. Yeah, let me write this name properly. Okay, bootstrap dropdown. Even D also lowercase characters. Okay. All right, so it is the name. So bootstrap dropdown dot spec dot js. All right, so let me run the step. Now it is started execution. So now we can see my test is executing. So currently we are not selected any options. By default HTML select CSS got selected, but here we are just checking the number of options present in the dropdown. So we're exactly expecting 11, so the total number of options also 11, so my assertion is got passed. And this is one assertion, so we can find total number of options in the dropdown. So the same thing we can also use by using length. And if you want to use length, again, we have to capture the options in the form of array. So in the previous video also, we have seen the same thing. In case of array, how can we do it? Just instead of locator, we just specify $. And say instead of locator, I can say $. So this will return all the options in the form of array in the options. And then I can put assertion. I can say await expect, then options dot length dot to be, how many options we are expecting? 11. So that's it. So we can get the options in the array format by using $, and then we are expecting options dot length should be 11. So this is another way to have the same kind of assertion. Now execute. So we have not selected any options so far. I'm just checking the total number of options present inside the dropdown. Perfect. So now I have seen the first one and the second one. So how to check the total number of options present inside the dropdown. So the main action. So how we can select option from the dropdown. So there are multiple options are there, right? We can also select multiple options from the dropdown. Now I'm going to show you how to select multiple options from the dropdown. Third one. So this is the action, which is exactly what we are going to do. So select options, multiple options, right, from dropdown. So how to select multiple options from the dropdown. So to select multiple options from the dropdown, same thing, we have to capture all the options one by one. Okay. And before selection, just I want to print those options. Okay. And once you get an options, then we will see how to select the options. So let us try to print them. So for that, what I'll do is first I will go to list item label. And this time I'm not taking input. Okay. Just want to print the header part also, the label. I'm taking only label part. And then we have to write one for loop here. Okay. For. And here, whatever options we capture, we will read each and every option into another variable. Let me create one let variable, let. Because this values keeps changing, I'm taking let. Let option of options. Now, observe here. So from the options, we are getting the first option or second round, third round, fourth round, depends on the number of options. This loop will be repeated multiple times. So once you take this option, now from this option, we want to capture the text value. Okay. So for that, I can say await option dot text content. So you can use text content, or there is another method called inner text. Option dot inner text. So this is also correct. Inner text or text content. Okay. So option dot text content. And this will actually returns the inner text of the option element. Okay. That I'm going to store in a variable. Let me take one variable value and I can make this as a const variable. Okay. Now what I'm doing is from the options, I'm getting the first option and capturing the text content in the value. Now I'm just trying to print that. So I can say in the console window, let's say console.log. And here, simply I can write the value is comma and say value. I'm just trying to print the values. We will see whether it is getting printing or not. And then I'll show you how to select the values. Okay, fine. So now let me save and then execute. So this time we are not going to validate anything. Just we want to get the options text values in and printing in the console window. Now, if I just look at this, we got exactly the same values. So these are the values we exactly got. So including headers, web development, programming, everything we got. So these are the different options which we have in the dropdown. Now, this is not our ultimate goal. So we have to select a particular option. So by default, HTML, CSS is already selected. Now I want to select some more options. Okay. So instead of printing this value, now I'll put one if condition. Whichever value you want to select, you can put this in the if condition. If the value includes, right? So the value includes which value we want to select. Suppose I want to select Angular. Let's say Angular. And also I want to select one more option. Let's say or again one more value dot includes. And suppose I want to select something else. Let's say I want to select Java also. Angular and Java. So I can put condition like this. Either the value equal to Angular or the value includes Java. Select them. So what I can say inside the if condition, await whatever option we captured above. On the same option, we have to perform click action. Option dot click. That's it. Okay, what exactly we are doing is, we are getting the option, each individual option one by one, and from the option getting the text content here. And then we are checking that value includes Angular or Java. Then go and click on that option. Once, for example, first time it get Angular and it is perform the click action. Then again, it will repeat the loop again. Second time it will get Java and then again click on the option. Other than these two, if you get any other options, it will not go and select. That means the condition become false. Okay, suppose in case, if you want to select only one value, right? Simply you can say value dot includes Angular, then click on the option and immediately break the loop so that it will not go to the other options. If I don't put the break, what will happen is it will keep repeating all the options in the drop down. So as soon as you selected whichever option you want, then immediately break, right? So this is how we can do it. So if condition, fine. So we have implemented. So we have selected all the options first, and we have read each and every option into the variable, then capture the text content, and checking that text content includes Angular or Java, then go and click on that option. Okay, so let us try to execute and see. Go to the file and save, and then execute. So now we can just observe Angular Java is also got selected along with HTML and CSS. Perfect, right? So suppose I want to unselect. So HTML, CSS by default, they are selected, right? So I want to just deselect. So simply what you can do is we can write another for loop. So you can just copy the same piece of code. And the next option is what? Deselect. Deselect options, whichever already selected. So what you can do, you can just comment this, the previous one. And this time we want to deselect. So what are the options you want to deselect? You have to specify that same loop, because if we already selected, it will deselect. If it is not selected, it will go and select. So HTML, you want to deselect. And then CSS also, I just want to deselect HTML and CSS. So save the script and then execute one more time. Now you can see CSS and HTML is got deselected. Okay. So this is how we can simply handle bootstrap dropdown. So different type of assertions we can add on the bootstrap dropdown elements. Okay. So that's all for this video. In the next video, we'll see another topic. Thanks for watching.